back to what we're really after. We're starting with a matrix that is a Hermitian. And because it's a Hermitian matrix, we know that we can find a matrix Q and a diagonal matrix lambda such that A is equal to Q lambda Q Hermitian transpose. That was known as the spectral decomposition. Okay. What does that really mean? Well, it means we were trying to find a unitary matrix Q such that Q Hermitian AQ is equal to a diagonal matrix. Let's relate what we have here to the computation of the QR factorization via Householder transformations. What happened there? What happened there was that we computed Q as a sequence of Householder transformations that were being applied to matrix A, and we ended up with an upper triangular matrix R. What if we similarly compute a sequence of Householder transformations such that the net result is equal to this diagonal matrix? It would be nice. Well, we're going to let you think about why inherently that can't happen. What we are going to show you is that we can compute a sequence of Householder transformations such that if we apply those to matrix A, we end up with a tridiagonal matrix. Okay? A matrix such that below the first subdiagonal and above the first superdiagonal, it only has zeros. Okay? And notice that it will be a tridiagonal matrix because of the Hermitian symmetry involved. The fact that matrix A is a Hermitian matrix. And how does this work? Well, we learned how to compute a Householder transformation such that if we apply that Householder transformation, we introduce zeros right here, all of the entries below the first diagonal entry. What we are going to do instead now is we're going to create such a Householder transformation, but with a 1 in the top left corner and zeros here. What did we learn happens if you apply that to a matrix? Well, if we choose this Householder transformation and compute it from this part of the first column instead of the full first column, then this Householder transformation can be created to introduce zeros right here. And let's put those zeros over here. Okay. And the fact that we put this one here just says, leave the first row alone. Now, what we notice from here is every time we apply a Householder transformation from the left, we should also apply it from the right. And therefore, let's see what happens if we take this Householder transformation and also apply it from the right. Now remember, a Householder transformation is its own Hermitian transpose, so I don't need to put a Hermitian transpose on here. The important thing is, when we now apply this from the right to this matrix, the first column of the matrix is not affected. So, these zeros that we just introduced here remain zeros. The second observation is that if A is a Hermitian matrix, then this right here is also a Hermitian matrix if these are Householder transformations. And what does that mean? That means actually that happily, we also introduce zeros right here. Okay. Now, next, we can look at this part of the second column and find a Householder transformation that creates zeros right here and apply that from the left and from the right. And when we do that, we end up with a matrix that looks like this. And by symmetry, right here. And then we can compute a household transformation from this part of the third column and third row. I guess we don't need to do that. That then introduces a zero right here. And what we've just described is a method that reduces the original Hermitian matrix A to a Hermitian matrix that's tridiagonal. Now, there are a couple of other insights that are important. One is, we know that if A is Hermitian, then the diagonal has real values on it. And it turns out that there is a post-process by which you can actually take any complex numbers that end up on the sub and super diagonal and make those real valued as well. So importantly, even if A starts by being a Hermitian matrix, one can actually perform the reduction to tridiagonal form in such a way that we end up with a real valued tridiagonal matrix, and all of a sudden we don't have to worry about doing our computation in complex arithmetic. The second observation is that, well, we're going to let you do this in homework, but you're going to see that the total computation for reducing the matrix to tridiagonal form is an order m cubed computation. So, if it's now the case that if we start iterating the QR algorithm with this tridiagonal matrix, if that means that each iteration becomes a lot cheaper, hopefully order m squared, then all of a sudden we've taken an impractical algorithm that cost order m to the fourth for the complete QR algorithm, and we've reduced that to something that overall is order m cubed. And that's where we're headed next.